2019 was just an extraordinary year for the company. We had 30% growth in revenues. We, for the first time, reported positive EBITDA before CARMA, which was $1.3 million, the first time we've actually crossed that threshold. We also signed 5 commercial deals and 1 in 2020 with Allogene Therapeutics, which is a very large allogeneic cell therapy company in the U.S. We also announced this morning that we have total milestones, pre-commercial milestones, of over $800 million in the 9 deals we have signed. And finally, we made great progress with CARMA as well. So across the board, launching new products, launching the expert platform, building out the sales and marketing infrastructure, making progress with our own clinical program, and then also making progress with a number of partnerships. So it was just a really excellent year for the team, and looking forward to an exciting 2020. Quite a bit of our business is in the cell therapy sector, and we did, again, strong growth in the cell therapy licenses. We launched Expert, which was our new platform that we're quite excited about. It includes not only new instrumentation, but also a new range of disposables and an enhanced regulatory filings for our customers and more field application scientists to help them accelerate their product development programs. Our consumables business, I just mentioned new products, has been very, very strong. And we're beginning to see now the receipt of these milestones I talked about before. These are early stage milestones, but they will build, we think, substantially over time. CARMA is progressing very, very well. We just announced the dosing of the first patient in our dose level 4 cohort. The dose level 4 cohort is the highest dose level we're giving these patients. This is we announced it that we completed, we initiated that first patient in the first quarter, which is what we, our expectation we have provided to the city. And the results of this trial will be reported at future scientific meetings, so we look forward to updating our investors on that part. And the other thing that's important is that we announced earlier this year, that early in 2020, that we established a new subsidiary for the CARMA Cell Therapy Group to be within as a subsidiary of Maxcyte. And we've also hired a group called Locust Walk. Locust Walk is a well-known investment boutique bank in the U.S. that focuses primarily in the life sciences, in particular in immuno-oncology and in cell therapy. So we're very pleased that they're working with us to develop the positioning of the business, and also to be leading us in our pursuit for new partnerships and independent ways of financing CARMA. And we hope to have that completed by the end of 2020. We began modifying our habits well over a month ago. And we've been on basically lockdown ever since, all of our field employees, as well as the team in Gaithersburg. Fortunately, we have adequate inventories to support our customers for quite some time, so we're good on the supply chain. I think we're taking a very positive but very realistic view of this, not quite sure when things are going to resume to normal or what the new normal will be. You know, we did provide an update recently, which provided a little bit more detail, so I'd like you to refer to that as if you're interested in what we're doing as a company. We are a global company, so we have staff in most of the major regions of the world, so we can keep very close with our customers. We do have a very resilient business model, as we've talked about in the past. Over 70% of our revenues are recurring, coming from license deals and disposables that are sold along with our instruments. And our partners are very well-financed blue-chip partners. And so their impact will be less, I think, than what you're going to see. They're all considered essential businesses. Many of them will have the financial capabilities to to get through this really difficult time for the global economy. We're being, I think, very realistic about this. We're expecting and have guided toward a very modest growth. And if you can refer to the publications by Trinity Delta and Pam Muir-Numis in terms of their projections, again, we're looking at a break even before CARMA this year. Again, the independent financing of CARMA, and then looking at new technologies for the development and new products. So we think a very busy and productive year. We're going to take this day by day and really try to understand how this impacts the health and safety of our employees, their families, and of course our partners, and eventually for the health and well-being of the patients that we serve.